Today we're going to take you through creating a chart for the first time in Stitchmastery and adding colour to that chart. It may be useful for me to point out that I am using Stitchmastery on a Windows machine, and if you're using a Mac, you'll see one small difference in your tool menu, which is that in place of the word file, you'll have the word Stitchmastery. So to create a chart, there are two different ways to go about this. Either we can come to File and open the New menu and click on the new chart diagram, or use Ctrl and N on your keyboard. Or the alternative is in the icon toolbar at the top of the program. Now, just draw your attention to this icon, the screen with a plus sign, and if we come back to the main screen, you'll see that that icon is there too, and hovering over it shows that this is the new chart diagram. So click on that, and the new chart diagram dialog opens. This gives you quite a few things to set up in the first instance, and the very first one is where you want your file to be saved. So you can use the browse button to go through your folders or locate an external hard drive or wherever you want to save your files. I'm happy with the desktop for now, that's quite useful for me. And I'm going to call this file Basic Introduction. Under the chart properties, you've a few fields that you can choose from. So the chart title, the number of rows and columns, what do you want the first row and column number to be? And there are various reasons you might want this to be something other than one. Where you want your column numbers to appear. What type of chart you're creating, so whether it's circular or flat. So obviously a circular chart will only have row numbers at one side, whereas a chart to be knitted flat will obviously have wrong side rows appearing on the left hand side, or a mosaic chart. And you also have diagram properties. These are a little bit more in depth and are all things that are explained in the manual, and I'm going to leave these all as they are for the purposes of this video. Click Finish. As you can see, the chart is completely full of knit stitches. And I'm going to just rearrange the screen a little so that we can see more of the chart itself. So to add colours, we come over to the stitch palette, and here we have lots of different folders of stitches. If you click on the folder, it will open and show you the stitches available. So we're going to use colours in this video. The program is set up with a selection of default colours to begin with, but you also have the option for a custom colour, and we'll come back to that in a moment. But first off, we'll add some dark green to the chart. So click on the colour, just one click and off. Bring your mouse or tracker pad over the chart itself, and you'll notice that my cursor has changed from an arrow to a paintbrush tool. And you can either click in individual cells, or you can click and hold and then drag over the cells to fill in one continuous motion. You will see that the key has automatically added the dark green, but it's also added white as an option because it now reads that the rest is to be knit in white. But you'll see we still have the knit symbol here, which may be confusing to a knitter, so you may well want to hide that. Your written instructions for your pattern will almost definitely explain that the knitter is to knit rather than any other type of stitch, so it's a bit surplus to requirements. And we can hide this, so click on the full stitch. So I've clicked on the word here, but what you want is to get the stitch and the icon selected, and come to Edit and Hide Selection, and that takes the knit out of your key. But you'll note that the output text still understands that everything in this chart is to be knit. It doesn't distinguish between the different colours, but it's very, very easy to get that included. Come to Diagram and Edit Diagram Properties, and in the Written Instructions tab, you'll see we have the include colour in written instructions and for repeated stitches. So we're going to select that box and click OK. And now you see the written instructions have regenerated to distinguish between the different colours. Of course, you might want to use colours that are different to those provided in the programme, and that's where the custom colour comes in. So we click on custom and a little dialog box opens. Now this is another thing that will be different if you're using a Mac, but you can see we have a wider variety of preset colours here, or we can come into define custom colours and there's a much broader range of colours available to you. So you can click and drag to move around the palette, and click and drag, or even just click, to set the level of light to dark. And when you're happy with the colour, click Add to Custom Colours, click on the colour itself and click OK. Now you'll note that the colour that you've created doesn't appear in the colours folder or the key just yet, but as soon as you click and start adding the colour to the chart, you'll see that your custom colour appears in the key and that the written instructions makes use of that. Very likely you don't want to call the colours in your chart custom colour, and there are two different ways you can change this. I'm going to go into the yarn menu, having clicked on the custom colour, and click Edit Yarn Properties, and you'll see that you have three options to change. You have the yarn name and the yarn alias. Now the yarn name you might wish to use for the full name and brand of the yarn, or if the yarn itself is referred to by a number rather than a word name. And the alias is what will be used in your output text, so you might just want to refer to, for instance, we might call this lilac. The yarn name might be, you know, a brand name and then the line of yarn and the colour number, which would be useful for the knitter to have in the key, but not so useful to have all of those words appearing every time in your output text. So just to show you how that works, I'll put JNS. JNS Lilac would not be called Lilac, but I don't have a number to hand, so we'll just go with that. Good, click Reset Yarn Text in Key, and that shows you what your text will show. And click OK, and your chart and written text will update. Now, one thing that is important to note is that Stitchmastery will not save your custom colours as part of your default library. The custom colour that you use in a chart will always be in that chart, so if I save this chart, close it all down, close the programme down, come back next week, I'll still have my JNS Lilac, no problem. But if I create a new chart and go to insert a colour, that will not be available to me. People have fed back to let us know that that is something that they would like, and it is on the to-do list for future developments in the programme, but at the moment you can't do that, so creating a new chart you would need to set up your custom colours again, just to make you aware of that. Something else to note when you're working with colour in charts, you're not confined to using knit stitches only. So if I wish to have some of the colour actually in purl, so for instance if it's colour work but in a flat item, then you can still do that. Choose your stitch and then draw over the stitches that you've got colour in. And we can also do the opposite. Start by placing the stitch and then colour the stitch in. And you'll note that the purl stitch that I've used here is displaying differently when there's colour behind it. And just to demonstrate, let's choose another colour, and you'll note that this one stays black. Now the reason for this is that in the diagram properties we initially set up, we have selected the stitch symbol colour automatically contrasts with yarn colour. So it means that your stitch symbols should always be contrasting with the colour of the yarn that you've put behind it. And the written instructions have updated, so we have knit 4 with white, purl with dark green, purl with yellow, knit with white, which is this round 8. And of course now we have a single purl symbol, and you may feel that actually you'd like to have the knit symbol back. And to do that, just select your key, come to edit, and show hidden items in selection, and we get our knit symbol back.